Good morning, children. How are you all? So in Saturday's class, we just went back. Just a recap was what is the constitution, we got it. And even what is this grammar of anarchy. So as I told you all, grammar of anarchy is a speech rendered by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar on 25th November 1949, a day before the constitution was formally adopted by the Constituent Assembly. Here he said that in order to achieve social and economic objectives, we have to take course of constitutional methods. He was against using of revolutionary methods such as satyagraha, civil disobedience and non-cooperation. So what is the reason behind this, children? They were only valid before independence, but they were invalid after the constitution came into force. This I explained you in the previous class, in your previous class. He called this method as grammar of anarchy, which means they represented anarchy. According to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, we Indians must hold fast to constitutional methods of achieving a social and economic revolution. We must abandon the methods of revolution as well as the methods of civil disobedience, non-cooperation and satyagraha. So these methods are nothing but the grammar of anarchy, and it is better for us if we abandon them earliest. So children, now we are looking at the Buddha and Hawaii. So now we are looking at Buddha and Tamil poetess Hawaii. Okay, opinion on caste division, children. So about 2500 years ago, the Buddha had questioned the caste division in India. He said, the only valid divisions are the divisions between those who are noble and wholesome and those who are ignoble and unwholesome. The Tamil poetess Hawaii had said similarly that there are only two castes in the world, namely the charitable who give and the superior. Okay, and are superior, and the misers who do not and are therefore inferior. Throughout the course of Indian history, great sages and saints exposed the hollowness of these divisions and sought to bring all the communities of India together in a creative partnership. But caste, by virtue of its power structure, showed itself to be firmly entrenched.